Good afternoon. It is Eric, the Big E Arnold, here in the sports barn on this Monday, September 13th. And we're here. This is our recap video. Monday, we try to, you know, bring you up to date on what we've been up to, what we've been doing, what's our record for the year, which I've always thought is a critical thing in following handicappers. Why would you listen to somebody if you don't know what the record is? So we keep track of that stuff here in the barn in an effort to be honest. So we'll bring you that. We have one MLB pick for you here today. One NFL pick on Monday Night Football. We put that out on a previous video. So you know that if you regularly follow these videos, but if you don't, well then because you don't, I'm not going to tell you now. You're going to have to wait till later in the show when I give it to you. So we got comments about our ongoing series about the world is being taken over by evil and what are you going to do about it. So let's get to our record so far this season. We'll do my friend here, Pittsburgh Louie, our guest handicapper. He's got more time than I do. Well, nah, I won't say that. He follows baseball exclusively from what I can tell. So I've been transferring my time more over to football now. And he's still on baseball. So last week, not a real great week for Louie. He dropped about 5 units last week. But he's still at plus 19.5, according to my records, for the season. It's good. It's still good. Nothing to sneeze at. Congratulations, Louie. We appreciate you. You're a big part of our show. So thanks for being here. Now, my record, I also had a... Well, as far as baseball goes, I had a kind of a substandard week last week. I dropped a couple units. I was upward of 28, 29 units in baseball. And now we're down to, 24.75. It's good. I mean, it's still above 500 in baseball. That's really good. You know, I got about a 5-unit lead over Louie here for the title, the inaugural sports barn title. I'd like to be the top baseball handicapper in my own channel. So I'm hoping that Louie, I've noticed, is starting to throw volume at it in an effort to up the units that he's winning, which I'm not sure is working for him. But he seems like he has, 6 picks today, 7 picks tomorrow, and then 19 picks the next day. We're playing these 5 games, run line and money line, which is, I think, a kind of a way you just double your bets. But at any rate, he's got 5 games to make up, so I don't know. He's got about 20 games left, so we'll see if he can catch me. So the bad news was my baseball picks last week, not so good. The good news is our football record, and I'm just lumping college and pro together, is, according to my numbers, 18 wins, 10 losses. 18 wins, 10 losses. That's pretty good. That's pretty good. You know, if you want to break that down into terms of units, that puts me over 30 units to the good for the season. So, hooray me. Yeah, I'm pretty happy about that. All right. And I'm sure there's some other channels out there that'll tell you right off the bat how good they are and how many units to the good they are this season. So, we're probably not as good as those other channels, but we're definitely winning here, and we have the receipts to prove it, so there's that. I've been given, I've been on and on about these vaccination mandates. Why have I been on and on about it? Because it's the worst goddamn thing I've ever seen in my lifetime. The worst! I mean, the only thing I could think that compares to it, possibly, would have been... And this is somewhat apples and oranges. Would have been perhaps the draft for Vietnam, but there, you're fighting a war, so you need soldiers to fight the war, so then you have to go out and get the soldiers. But, you know, Vietnam was such a boondoggle, a disaster, a war that should have never been fought. But, of course, at the time, maybe it wasn't that obvious. And that was not within my lifetime for the most part. I'm 53. You do the math. But, I that seems like a similar type thing where the government is singling out a group of people and says, you, we're going to damage you. We're going to hurt you. And that group of people goes, what do I get out of it? Nothing. You get fucked up the ass. That's what you get. You get absolutely nothing. So that's kind of where I'm thinking that the worst thing that could possibly be compared to this. And it's going to get worse. Biden and his handlers have signaled already over the weekend that they've got more restrictions coming for the unvaccinated, as if trying to take their jobs isn't enough. It's like, what else can they do to these guys? I thought about that. It's like, well, I guess the obvious thing that they could do is you got to make these people mark them in some way. I mean, how do I know to stay away from an unvaccinated person? They look like all the rest of us. I'm vaccinated, in case this is the first time you've ever been here. I'm vaccinated, so, you know, you can't tell, though. I don't have a hole in my arm where they stuck the needle in. So how do I know to stay away from these deadly, dangerous, contagious, unvaccinated people? I don't know. Maybe we could mark them in some fashion, like with a, I don't know, an armband or a, well, you got to put something on the armband. I don't know, maybe a star. Yeah, a star on an armband. We could do that. You know, now, of course, you say, well, I don't understand. If you don't know anything about your history, that's what the Nazis did to the Jews. They made them wear the Star of David on their on an armband so everybody knew right away, hey, that's a Jew. You know, oh, here's a Jew. We need to be careful. That guy's Jewish. So, and now, and if you're getting all upset, saying, this is ridiculous, this is Joe Biden is not a Nazi. Okay, I'm just saying. The Nazis at the beginning of their reign most certainly did single out the Jews, and they punished the Jews, and they punished that group of people, and blamed that group of people for everything that was wrong with their society. Does any of that sound familiar? So this is where it starts. I'm just saying, this is the start of this is identical to the start of that. Your point is, well, that's never where it's going to end up. It'll never end up with these people being slaughtered in camps. That's ridiculous. Yeah, maybe, yeah. I mean, if your crystal ball is so clear that you can see that far down the road, no, it doesn't happen. No, it's not going to go that way. Well, I'd like to look into your crystal ball just so I can figure out whether the Raiders are going to win tonight or not. Can I do that? But at any rate, but the beginning, identical, just saying. And that's to my Democrat friends out there that don't think this is such a bad idea to force a group of people to do something that they absolutely do not want to do, and of which the benefit, if they actually did this act of taking the vaccination shot, as if that would magically make everything all better. I'm not even going there for the most part, just because let me get this straight. I'm vaccinated, but somehow that guy that's not vaccinated, he's a hazard to me, but I'm vaccinated. What are you saying, that this vaccination doesn't work? Well, then why does he need to get it so bad? You know, it doesn't make any sense, but, you know, it makes perfect sense if you look at it in the terms of, this is just a cynical political act to divide us and keep this pandemic going forever because the elites in this country are making hay over left, right. They're accumulating power. They're accumulating money. They hope to keep this goddamn thing going forever. And then by doing such, they'll subjugate us, have their great reset, and then we'll all be living as serfs, begging for fucking food like Oliver Twist. Please, sir, may I have another bowl of gruel. So that's why we keep talking about this, because it's important. It's incredibly important. You know, I was thinking about the corporation's role in this, and you know, it's a kudos to Biden and his handlers, his Marxist handlers. You know, their strategy is sound, that, hey, we'll just throw it off on the corporations. They're soulless organizations that'll do whatever we tell them, no matter how evil it is. I mean, it's the Milgram experiment all over again. I told you about that, you people. The Milgram experiment was something in the 60s. Basically, it was the conclusion is you can take a normal person and you can make them do evil things as long as you stand behind them and pat them on the head as an authority figure and say, don't worry, it's all cool. No, don't think. Just, we got this. It's all good. Just do what I'm telling you. No, don't think about whether it's immoral or not. Just do it. And they do it. And these corporations will do it too. I looked up some of these corporations that were involved in the Holocaust, and it's on the internet. You can look it up too. But it was somewhat surprising to me. I mean, you don't think about it, do you? You never really think about that. It's like, well, who built that rail car that they shoved the Jews into on their way to the death camp? Who built the oven? You know, who did this stuff? I mean, how did they help these guys? Well, Mercedes-Benz, Volkswagen. Here, I had a list, and it was by no means a total list. I just wrote down some of the obvious ones that jumped right out at me. Nestle, IBM, Deutsche Bank. They're still, I mean, all these companies are still around. Barclays Bank, BASF. I think BASF, that's like, what were their little cute commercials, I think, making things better. Well, they're the ones that helped make the chemicals that they dropped into the death houses to kill people, making things better. Bayer, you know, these are all companies that are still in business today that were either actively involved in the Holocaust or benefiting from it. And I could think of these guys sitting around their boardrooms going, man, you know, this really is wrong that we're involved in this stuff. It really is. What are you going to do? I mean, and you got to admit, since we stopped paying the workers and it's all slave labor, man, we're making out. Woo, look at the bottom line. These Nazis, I mean, they're humorless assholes, but boy, we've been making some money since we threw in with them. And what happened to the people on the board of directors of these companies? Nothing. Were they punished? Hell no. These companies are all still in business today. So it the same thing here in this country, you know, in the Civil War. The businesses in the South, we called them plantations, but they were businesses. You know, these huge farms, if you will, call them plantations. These guys were making money hand over fist, and they would not change their business models. You know, they could have paid those guys. They could have paid the slaves and done away with it, but they didn't want to. Hell no. That's crazy. We'd have to compete with the North, where they're actually paying some of their immigrant labor. Yeah, I had a guy one time argue with me with a straight face that the way the North treated their immigrant labor was basically the same as the South, and the way the Southern states treated their labor, the slaves. And I'm like, what the hell are you talking about? Well, they were treated the same. They had the same economic opportunity, none. They made about the same amount of money, none. They had to work the same hours. It's like, bullshit. That guy in the North, that Irish immigrant in the North, he had an opportunity to go do whatever he wanted. If he didn't want to work in the sweatshop, he could go west and make his fortune. He could work in some other sweatshop. He could try to bust his ass and get above sweatshop worker and become head of the sweatshop. Or he could go open up his own store and sell things to the workers of the sweatshop. All kind of Irish people and Germans came over in the 19th century and worked their way up the ladder because they were not slaves and they had freedom to go do this stuff. So I just was ridiculous. I thought that the plantations down there, they could have paid their guys. They could have paid their guys and, you know, there would have never been a civil war, but they didn't, you know. So I don't know, this rant about corporations, they're going to do whatever the soulless, immoral government tells them to do. So it's up to us to stand there and say, we're not doing this. This is wrong. The corporations aren't going to do it. The corporations aren't going to get this illegal, soulless, immoral, evil law from the government going, I'm not doing that. That's ridiculous. They're going to line up and go, hell yeah, that's really, this helps us because this takes out the uncertainty of litigation. And, you know, if we lose employees because they quit, well, we'll just buy new guns. We really don't care too much about that. We're more worried about litigation. So we're covered. This is great, man. So they don't care. They're not going to step in front of a bullet for this illegal order. It's up to us to stop this thing. And as I pointed out to my friend, the union worker with his gun collection, if you don't step in front of this, they're coming for your guns rapidly. It's not going to take them long either. Then what are you going to do? I'm going to leave you with this before I get to the picks. Or I may give you this twice. I may give it to you now. And then for all you people that don't listen and go right to the picks, which is probably most of you, I'm going to give it to you again. First, this comes from Martin Niemöller. Now, I know a lot of you people probably heard this, but I think a lot of you have not. Or don't know where it came from, or don't know the context of it. So he couldn't have been that. He was a Lutheran preacher, Lutheran pastor in Nazi Germany, imprisoned, locked up for like 7 years with everybody else that stood up to Hitler. Luckily survived. After the war, he said these words about the Nazis and their rise to power. Martin Niemöller. First, they came for the socialist. And I did not speak out because I was not a socialist. Then they came for the trade unionists. And I did not speak out because I was not a trade unionist. Then they came for the Jews. And I did not speak out because I was not a Jew. Then they came for me. And there was no one left to speak for me. And you can go ahead and you can throw anything in there you want, and it still applies. Throw unvaccinated in there. That you can put that in there. It works just as well. All right, let's get to the picks. Now, if you missed it, we were going to take the Raiders tonight. Just think they're going to have we won 3 of our games yesterday, lost 1. Off to a good start. I don't know. I just think the Raiders are going to have a huge, amped up, first time out crowd in that place they have out there. And I'm just trying to draw a little equivalency there to the hockey team, that Golden Knight team, when they had their first year with fans and they were unbeatable at home. So I'm kind of thinking the Raiders are going to have a huge, huge crowd, and they're going to be amped up to the max. And I just don't think the Ravens right now are going really in the right direction with all their injuries and what have you. So, Raiders. Baseball, we're going to look at the Astros tonight. We're going to take a shot with them. A little bit of a high price. But the Astros, for the most part, have been playing pretty solid, consistent baseball. They're pulling away from their competition. Really, I don't know it's anything so much the Astros are doing, but the A's and Mariners are just wearing out. But the Astros are just playing consistent, you know, 570, 600 baseball, winning 2 out of 3, winning 2 out of 3, lose a series here or there, but then win 2 out of 3. So they're just playing pretty consistent ball. The Rangers are getting better, but you know, I think this is a good spot where the Rangers just took 2 out of 3 in Oakland. They're happy. They're all smelling. They feel pretty good. Now they're coming home. I just think this is a spot that the Astros are better suited to win this game than the Rangers. The Astros want to keep playing decent baseball. They do not want to get into a tailspin heading into a five-game playoff. Spencer Howard going for the Rangers. He's been bad. Jake Odorizzi going for the Astros. He's been pitching pretty well, even though he's on the bottom of their starting rotation. He's pitching to get into the playoffs. In other words, this is a guy that wants the ball at some point in the playoffs. He wants to be a part of the team. He doesn't want to be an afterthought, a guy in the bullpen. He wants to start in the playoffs. Plus, then he's heading into his contract year or two, so he wants to position himself well for that last year of his contract so he can get one more good year and then hopefully one more good payday before he retires. So all these reasons, I think this is an Astros spot here. We'll lay the price, and I think there's still some room on the top of that, whatever it is, 185. I think there's still some room up there that this probably should be upwards of 220, 230. There you have it. That's what we got for you. I think what we're going to do going forward here is I think we're looking at three shows a week. I think we'll do the recap show on Monday. Somewhere midweek, we'll do a college football show with the picks. Maybe Friday, we'll do the picks with the NFL, and that's going to be it. With the number of views we're getting, it's just not worth trying to do a show every day or every other day. So I think that's angling where we're looking. You'll probably get the same content. What I may do is in the interim, days, if I feel like I got something to say, I'll just make a political video and then you can skip that at your leisure. And so I don't know what happened to all those Trump people. I've got like 360 some subscribers, of which 20 actually watched the video. So I don't know where all those Trump people went. This vaccination mandate. See, I kind of have this sneaking suspicion. A lot of Trump people want the mandates. You haven't seen Donald Trump run out and grab a microphone and say, "This is outrageous. This is terrible. This is un-American." Because I think secretly he wants the mandates just like Biden and his handlers do. There's a definite a streak in Trump that would force people to do things. And there's a word for it, which I cannot pronounce at the moment. But at any rate, there's that. Any rate, first they came for the socialists, and I was not a socialist, so I did not speak out. Then they came for the trade unionists, and I was not a trade unionist, so I did not speak out. Then they came for the Jews, and I was not a Jew, so I did not speak out. Then they came for the unvaccinated, but I had been vaccinated, so I didn't speak out. And then when they came for me, no one was left. I'll leave you with that. Signing off.